Hi, I'm Isaiah, and this is my little son, Dimitri.
Hi, it's Yvonne. This is Katie Reese.
And we are the Gun Family.
When I first got the egg babies, I was really excited.
I was like really nervous and really scared because for some reason I treated these eggs like real babies for like the first 5 minutes. And then after that, I was just like, okay, they're just eggs. All I have to do is carry it around and I'm done. But yeah, that was at first. During the project, I found it was so difficult to do any of the normal things I used to do. Like, I took my kids down to the gym with me, and I had them in one hand, I was trying to play basketball with the other, and it was horrible because I couldn't set them down because I was afraid some basketball was gonna like hit the babies. Using the bathroom was hard, and just the idea of taking them everywhere I go, I just felt embarrassed because I thought people would think I was like a real parent or something, and I just thought it was really hard to have children, even if they don't cry or move.
Oh yeah, I think it gets harder as it goes on because I got bored and tired of carrying it around, and I just got bored after 2 days.
2 days
after the project started. Okay.
I think we both can say that we felt free after this project, and that what Ms. Phillips was teaching us while we had these children was that we're all selfish and that we don't care about anyone but ourselves, and that these babies would all be dead eventually because we would probably neglect them or not love them enough or pick them up, because I don't swear, I only touched them. I only like picked up my babies like once, and that was like in the first 5 minutes of having them. After that, they're in the basket the whole time. So, bad parents here. I think after what I learned from this project is that I can't even raise myself properly. If you haven't seen my room, I can't even clean that. So I can't take care of a child and raise them and give them food or diapers. I don't have a job, and I probably have to drop out of school just to, you know, become a good parent, which I really don't want to do.
I learned that I am really selfish, and I'm not ready for kids right now. And I know that if I have kids right now, I wouldn't take good care of them.
Best moments? I honestly don't think there are any best moments. I mean, they're eggs. What am I supposed to do with them? Buy them a churro from Disneyland? I don't think so. Like, all I did was leave them at home and do nothing with them.
Yeah, that's what I do too, because when I got home, I just put it on a table and then I don't pay attention to them.
Yeah, so
we didn't have any best moments.
Although for worst moments, I'm pretty sure that means every time I left the house without them, which is like going to the gym, going to the movies, going to the mall, and or even when I even get home, I just put them on the kitchen table and just do my own thing for like 5 hours, and then I didn't interact with them. That's my worst moment.
One of my worst moments was that when I was halfway to Big Bear last weekend, and I realized that I left them at home for the whole weekend. I mean, yeah, that was my worst moment.
You left your kids for. Yeah, anyways. Our responsibilities as parents should be to be perfect role models and for the children. So I'm sorry for yelling at you.
Okay,
thank you. Did you see that, kids? Parents here. Anyways, being role models for children, and that you actually have to love your children, and not unlike these eggs where you just put them somewhere and just leave them in there, like in your closet or something. But you actually have to like pick them up, love them, and make them understand that you love them, or else they won't make it in life, or they won't grow up without knowing what love is. And traits?
Trials.
Worries. I guess worries would be that if we have children, not together, I mean, but like if we each have children or something, I guess like how we raise them, if we want to raise them like our parents raised us, or that like if we do a good job as parents, and that if they don't turn out the way we expect them to turn out or hope they turn out, I guess it's our biggest worry. And I guess the joy comes from knowing that you help somebody, or like help yourself kind of, because it's like a miniature you. You help like a small part of you become a better person, and the joy comes from like raising them from being a baby, and that's just a good experience to have. Which is why these kids are no joy, because they just stay in age.